Right, welcome back. Before I drill this shank out, I think the best thing is to heat it up and let's see if we can get all these bends and what have you out of it. Because if we have to do any work up here and there's a hole drilled down the end of the shank, it's going to be weak, it's going to crack. So while we've got solid timber there, we'll just work on the whole thing and see what we can do with it. Now, obviously you've got a sight along your shank and see where the real dog legs are. And this is particularly bad one, this. You'll be able to see possibly some really nice bends in this. What I like to do is a bit of chalk, mark up what's particularly bad, and then we can concentrate on that. Ideally, you want to really start at the end and then work your way along the shank till you get to the end. Then you're not disturbing anything that you do here. You will find, though, as you heat things and bend things, other bends will probably appear, because this is not just a straightforward bend. You'll probably find this is a compound bend, let's call it. So it's not going to bend just in one direction. It'll be awkward and bend in a number of directions at the same spot. So it's not a 5 minute job, but it is worth doing if you want to get this nice and straight. So I think what I'll do is settle these two big bends here first, and just to give you an idea of very simple things I use, I have a couple of blocks, you see, and that one just puts pressure on the high spot and bends it in. We've also got a very old fashioned notch system which you can swing on, and then in the end, you know, it's quite easy just to pop your shank in a protective jaws, of course, and just pop it in there and give it a tweak. So there we go. So we'll put this back and we'll start heating up. I should really have an elastic band on that one. It's broke, and I haven't got round to getting another one for it, so I just tend to put up with the way it is. Okay. Just to get your hot air gun up to speed, and if you're impatient like me, you can use two in one hand, and then run along the shank where you want to put your heat, or where you want to do your bending straight with. So I'm probably about an inch and a half or thereabouts away from the shank, and the thing is, keep the hot air guns moving. You can impart heat without scorching, hopefully, the bark. So just have to be patient at this point. Normally, if I didn't have the camera here, I would be working that way. My shank would be lying on there, and I'd be heating away here. So the vise is a very good little notch to rest your shank on. And if you don't already know, the idea of heating the timber up is to soften the fibres, and that makes them pliable, and you can then try and put a bit of pressure on the bend and straighten it up. And this technique's been used for millennia. Ancient man used to heat his sticks over a fire and straighten them to make arrows. So we're just doing what's always been done, but with modern technology. Now, while we're doing this, a few people might think, well, that's a peculiar material to use, plywood, but I first saw this used probably 20 odd years ago, maybe longer, and there was a very, very well known stick maker called Hayden Wood, and we used to see him at various stick making competitions, especially at a place called Harden Wood, which was a sheepdog trials. and he would make these plywood crooks with a thistle on the nose, and they were very, very nice, very beautiful, and the sheepdog people liked them a lot. Very, very durable sticks. If you drop them, they're not going to break, and they're cheap enough to make, so as I say, good material. And Hayden used to use all sorts of different things. He was an absolute excellent stick maker, especially in ram's horn and buffalo horn. And there are one or two stick makers about who were brought under his wing. And you can still see Hayden's style in these stick makers' crooks. That's pretty hot. That'll be enough. I'll just switch these off now. See what we can do. So you need to check where your where the offending bend is. Pop that in there. And give it a bit of a twist. You want to get to a point where you don't want to really go past where you think you should be, because often then you put a bend in the opposite way. Just give it a bend and let it spring back a little bit, and then just check it. Oh, that's a bit better. But as I say, these are compound bends, and you'll now find that there's one going in a different direction. And you'll find this with straightening sticks, it's a lot of tweaking. There's a lot of tweaking, especially where you've got knots and things. Sometimes they are reluctant to come out. Do a bend, check it. You want to check it against light, obviously. I have skylights in here, so I've got natural light coming in. Well, that's not too bad. It's nowhere near perfect. So I'm going to work up here now. I've got those nasty offending bends almost out. This too hot air gun technique is very good on ram's horn. Ram's horn, especially the big horns that I tend to get, do take a lot of heating. So if you can hold two in your hands at the same time, it does speed things up a little bit. But again, keep your hot air guns moving. Don't burn your material. Let's see what that's like. It's quite hot. I'm just going to use the other let's call it a jig, just to show you what's what. I might actually be going in the wrong direction here because of the camera being there. But what we're going to do is see which way the bends go in, and find a notch that fits. And all you have to do is just swing on that and try and take the bend out. Now that's very simple to make. Just notches, and I put thick leather on there so it doesn't mark the shank up, the bark up too badly. I'd say alternatively, you can always just use your vise. Pop it in there, and that's up, a wee bit of a bend. That's not too bad. So we've got a bend here where we were before. And so as you work on one, you'll find you're disturbing the timber elsewhere, and something else will pop up. So there's more there. Anyway, I'm sure you've got the general idea now. That's all I basically use. I use that idea, these two blocks. Very simple. A lot of people use very, very similar things. Just use that. People bend sticks over the knees. They have all sorts of methods. Whatever works for you is good. So we're going to stop there. We're going to carry on off camera with this, straighten it up, come back, and then we're going to drill the end of the shank.